Hi guys, hi everyone. Welcome everyone to Edureka's session. My name is Abresh and I'm going to take you through this journey, which will be a full-fledged knowledge and information about Selenium. What is Selenium? What all things you should know about it before you enroll for a course? So let's get started with a little understanding what is this Selenium all about and how we can use Selenium, or what all knowledge you should have in terms of Selenium. Okay, so how many of you are having a little idea about Selenium? I will give you a little idea about my version of understanding with Selenium so that you get a little more understanding as well as you understand the need of it. Okay, first of all, why there is a need of automation testing, or why the industry is growing? Let's understand that aspect first. So when we talk about automation testing, the first thing that you need to understand is, in the market, whichever type of industry it is, when it comes to automation, specifically for software industry, basically software related industry, everybody first thought process will go towards Selenium. You know why? Reason being, first of all, if you are talking about automation, the first purpose is speed. Second is accuracy. You want speed of execution. You want to increase the speed of execution of things, whatever you're doing. You want to reduce the manual intervention. You want to increase the quality of outcome. You want to reduce the manpower that you are hiring as a company. And you want to do more work within the time that you have. So speed, accuracy, more better results, and quick feedback. And along with that, less human resource. If there are so many benefits, why not go to automation? And this is one of the reasons why industry is moving towards automation testing very, very fast. And you might have heard of AI, digital presence of AI, and when we talk about machine learning and all those sort of things, they've got a boom in the market. Why there is a boom? Because that they are actually targeting to save your time. And human involvement, they're trying to reduce the human involvement, which means dependency on more on the machine. But in automation testing, it is not doing that completely. It is helping you to do the things faster, but the dependency of human is still present. This is the only industry which is not going to get impacted by the AI industry, and it is very, very tough in the market right now. As per my knowledge, as per my research, it is going to be very less chances where AI will touch this market very good way. So Selenium is one such tool which is available for free. You do not have to pay anything. It's an open source product. That means anybody around the globe can contribute for its improvisation. Selenium supports multiple operating systems, multiple programming languages, and multiple browsers. This makes it more compatible and more user-friendly for the users who are specialized into a particular domain. Like somebody who is a Python expert can also use Selenium. Somebody who is a Java expert can use Selenium. So any programming language you know, if you know any programming language, you can work with Selenium, and there's no constraint that you have to learn something new. Somebody who is an expert into something, Selenium will not ask the person to jump to a particular programming language. This is the beautiful part of Selenium. All the other products available in the market, very commonly known QTP, very popular product apart from Selenium, if somebody is talking about, is QTP is very much popular, which is a premium tool. It costs you around a lakh of rupee, somewhere around $1,000 for a user, which is very high cost. And on top of that, you need a very high-end machine. You need any specific programming language knowledge only. So this leads to more complexity. And this is why Selenium has more advantages than any other tool in the market. It is one such tool which can work with any kind of environment. It can work with any kind of tool integration. So it supports multiple tool integration. And it is one such tool which focuses on one area, which is web automation. If it is focusing on one area, but it is the master of that area. So they are working on a segment which is their mastery. So if you talk about web automation, the first thing that any expert will also talk about is Selenium. You look into, you do a research, you talk to anybody who is a web automation expert and you tell them that, do you know Selenium? You'll say, what are you asking? I can't live without Selenium. If I have to stand into the automation industry, I need to know Selenium because that's the first thing every company will ask for. So even those company who are having a product like QTP, I have delivered training for them for Selenium. So you can see the power of Selenium. So that is the reason if you go to Selenium website also, which I'll show you, they have a very plain statement mentioned on the heading. Selenium automates browser. That's it. You don't say anything about it. That is enough for the point. What you do with that power is entirely up to you. What you want to do, you decide. We are not going to tell you what to do. We are going to make sure that what you want to do, it is compatible for it. That's the basic aim that they have put up. And it's not focusing on automating web application alone, but it also gives you a liberty to automate your daily activities that you do on a web application. You can automate those repetitive activities that you do on a web application. Maybe your office related applications, or maybe an application which you are using in your office, but on a daily basis, you have to do some repetitive task. You can automate that also, this level of control that Selenium gives you. So Selenium is such tool which helps you to do automation on a web application. So any application that can be accessed on a web browser can be automated with Selenium. This is the control that you get with Selenium. Now I gave you a good amount of idea. What is Selenium? It is an open source tool. It is available for free. It can do wonderful job with any kind of automation, be it difficult level or simple ones. Any feature that is there on a web browser, you can automate with Selenium. Or if Selenium does not support you, there it is always a supportive functionalities available in the market which will be integrated with Selenium and you can use it. So your task is completed in any case. So it's not a hurdle that you cannot do it. It's just your knowledge who will tell you how much you can automate. Selenium is not just one tool. Yes, that's correct. So what you're hearing is correct. Selenium is a suite of tool wherein you have IDE, integrated development environment. The second tool that is there in the suit is WebDriver. And the third one is Grid. And out of this, WebDriver is the most important part that you have to focus, because this has so much of control that it can automate any kind of functionality available in a web browser. Any sort of functionality. You talk about e-commerce, you talk about banking, you talk about any edtech brands, any website of LMS or any kind of applications you have. So all sort of things you can automate with WebDriver. And that is the reason it is the most preferred product in the market. Grid is just a supporter for WebDriver. So even Grid is popular. IDE is an integration. It's basically an UI based plugin on browsers. You can use it on an initial level, basic level testing you can do with this tool. But WebDriver can do wonder. Now, when we talk about Selenium, Selenium, as I said, it can automate web browser. But if you want to automate web browser, you need to interact with the web elements. So in a web browser, in any web browser, so you may have a website, you have a text box, you have a radio button, you might have a button, right? So all these things are to be located. You need to locate them on a web application, which will make the WebDriver or Selenium to find that element uniquely, and then your action can be performed. Fair enough? So locator technique is important. If you want to locate any element on a web page, you need locator techniques, and these locator techniques will help you to locate the element properly. Now, I have 10 text boxes on a web page. How can I tell the system that go and type in the sixth one only? I need to give something uniqueness, right? So that is what locator technique will give, and it will help you to locate the elements on the web page, and this will help you to achieve towards the success, right? So locator techniques are various types of techniques. One of the most popular technique is XPath, which we will be covering in the live sessions. We will not be able to cover everything in a very short span of time, but XPath is the most popular locator technique, where in our modules we actually cover in a very in-depth manner. We make you master on XPath. You know why? XPath is basically a technique which can work with any element, and it can help you to locate any web element on the web page. That is the reason 90% of the companies always prefer the whole team to be forcing them to use only XPath. And most of the projects that you do in a real-time environment, you will be asked to use XPath throughout your project. Don't use any other locator technique, just use XPath. And that is the reason we also understand the need of the market. We focus completely on XPath, and this is one of the reason I have a short video on XPath, which you can actually Google on YouTube also. You can look for XPath in Hindi by Edureka. So somebody who can understand the Hindi language, you can actually watch the video. This has a good understanding, but I have not, it was not a in-depth explanation, but it was just a basic idea of what is XPath. So there is a video like this, which will give you a little insight of my teaching also. It's done by me only. Similar experience, but in a very, very deep manner, I go for XPath in the classes. I make it mastery because this is your heart of Selenium. If you want to learn Selenium, you need to master XPath technique, and you need to learn how to locate any kind of element. If you can't do that, the rest of the journey is useless. Because even if you know everything about Selenium and your locators are not working well, things are not going to work. Because this is the most important part. If you can't locate the button, how will you click on it? Or how will you complete your task? So this is the most important thing that you need to focus. So we focus on this on a very in-depth manner. Now, coming back to a very important part, in our Selenium course, we not only cover most of the topics of Selenium, but we also have one of the important topics called as TestNG. TestNG is, what is this TestNG? It's a framework or a tool which is designed to do a wonderful job for a person who is using it. In a very simple way, I'll tell you, it's a wrapper to your chocolate which adds value to the chocolate. And here the chocolate is basically your Selenium, and the wrapper is TestNG. TestNG adds value to your code. What you do with Selenium, you do the same thing with TestNG, but in a structural way, which represents the information in a very fine manner to make sure that your work is more smooth, more easier, less effort. This is one of the reason TestNG is one of the most popular product attached to Selenium. And if you see in the market, if somebody is going for a Selenium profile, they don't even mention TestNG in the profile requirement document or the JD. Why they don't mention? Because it's predefined or pre-understood that it is a must known topic. This is must. That is the reason they don't talk about anything apart from this. I am going to walk you through a practical exposure of TestNG, where some people might be able to grasp the things. because it's a very short period of time for me to give you so much of knowledge. So I'll give you a short example wherein you will get an idea how things actually get automated with Selenium and how wonderful it is. This product itself is such a wonderful product. You will understand that. I'll show you a sample example. It's a ready-made material. I'm not spending time in writing the code, which you will see in the real classes, basically the live classes that we conduct. When you enroll for the course, you get to see how we write all in-depth knowledge. When I write the code, I keep on speaking about the code also. So that's my habit. I go in depth of everything and I keep on explaining things. So you have to be very attentive and listen to me, and you get so many things in a short period of time. So that's the beauty of the teaching that I do. I make sure that whatever is being taught to you is knowledgeable, productive, and useful for you in the market. So the focus is towards making you confident to stand out into the market and make sure that you get a job opportunity also. Now, here, TestNG, why it is required, very much important question that you might have. Like, okay, you said it acts as a wrapper to the chocolate, but why it is actually required? If Selenium can do everything, then why we need TestNG? So the purpose why we need TestNG is wherever Selenium is lacking is in terms of two important things. One is the designing structure is not there. The coding structure is purely dependent on the developer who is writing the code. Developer means tester only over here. The tester who writes the code can decide the coding techniques that he wants to implement, but there is no defined, predefined structure which can make standard throughout the team. And the other part is very important part is Selenium does not give you any kind of output, report outputs. There's nothing called as report in Selenium because it is a tool designed for processing the things rather than displaying of things. So they never came up with any kind of plugins which can help you to get a report output. So we always have to rely on the third party plugins, which is like TestNG, then you have Extend Report, and then you have Log4j. A lot of things are there in the market. So we use those things as a supportive hand. Now TestNG is one such tool which fulfills multiple roles, okay, which basically helps you to do multiple things. One is running from one single file, I can run multiple file in a sequential pattern is possible with TestNG. Secondly, TestNG relies on the XML file, which is basically the heart of TestNG. And XML file helps you to run the code in your pattern the way you want. So whole configuration can be done. Not only configuration, but it adds value by giving you reports. A report which is basically very, very important for everybody as an automation engineer. But these reports are basically standard reports in three formats. You get the report. Any format you can implement for your use. That's the beauty of TestNG. These are the few set of information that I'm showing you. I will walk you through some sort of code. I will show you some kind of examples which will help you out how things can work out for you in terms of automation testing and in terms of a lot of things. So I'll give you a quick run through a project which is which you learn in your journey. Basically the same project you will be learning throughout your journey. You to reach to this project, you have to spend 36 hours. So that's the quick understanding that you will get. So when it comes to TestNG, I'll just show you some of the code with respect to the TestNG part. So this is the kind of TestNG example that we have. Here I'm opening the browser and I'm opening the URL over here, which is my own blog URL. And here we are reading from an Excel sheet and we are getting the data from the Excel sheet. And then we are going to perform the actions on the application. So this is a pure example of a hybrid framework that we are going to see. This includes BDD framework, data-driven framework, TestNG, and a lot many other things. Apache POI is there, page object modeling concept is there. So whatever is being taught in the whole course journey, you will get to know everything in depth, and you will be doing this kind of projects at the end of the day. which we will see the execution quickly. So you get a feel of what happens at the end of the day. Now it's time for us to relax and sit and see what execution takes place. So if everything is ready somewhere, some things are missing. Yes, something are missing. Oh, yes. So probably I have not set up this. I will run it from a class like this. Right click, run as, and here we go. So you can see I am not touching my system anymore. So you can see this. It's going and filling up the form quickly. So within a few fraction of seconds or maybe a minute, you were able to execute around 20 data. You were able to fill up the form 20 times, 10 or 20 times something. Yeah, I keep on changing the thing. So maybe 10 times or 20 times. This is what we get as a result, like what happened in every execution. We are printing that also. Along with that, we are getting a report also, which I'll show you. Okay, sorry, here, not here. But we will be able to see the report over here. I have not implemented the report, I guess. So this is a demo project that I've done. Not focusing more on the outcome, but yes, here it is, I guess. So after a very long time, I'm touching this particular project. This kind of information we get out as an outcome, but you can really customize these outcome to the level what you want as an output. I want something to be visually available like this, what happened in every execution. If you want to track that, you can do that. So Amit Jain, Gujarat will be placed over here. So whatever information I'm trying to enter, it is clearly mentioning everything, what I am doing in the execution. So you get all sort of information like this. You can keep this information either in the console, you can enhance it, you can go with all the set of things, right? So everything that you see right now is clearly specifying what things you have done in an application, and everything is mentioned over here, right? So this way it will be replaced over here. So you get a print statement, you get everything, and in the coding also, this is the level of code that you'll be designing, what you have over here, how to call the methods, how to use testng concepts. So I'll just show you the testng class. I will show you the rest of the classes also. So you have base class, which basically talks about which browser you want to, you can decide which browser you want, which browser you want to use, everything. With reading aspects, I want to read an Excel sheet, which is basically over here. Property file, I'll go to the path. I'll show you the file also. Here it is, the data. So some sort of information that you get inside this, you will be able to read the material. You will be able to pass the material into the code. That's the beauty of framework. To reach to this thing, you have to complete a lot of things. You need to learn how to write the code, how to work with it, how the process works, what is the right coding techniques, how you should process the things, how you should grow your code, how you should make it more reusable. All those things, I will be giving you enough of knowledge in terms of training during the live classes. You will learn all sort of things about Selenium. So this is about Selenium and TestNG. TestNG gives you a little insight on how you can represent the information, some sort of information that you want to execute in a particular pattern. You can do that also. One of the examples, if you want, I can show you with respect to dependency. I'll go for this. So this is a sort of code which basically says that I want to do something. Okay, so here I'm opening up the browser, I'm performing some opening of the URL, then I'm going to a particular page, like clicking on a login button, and it is taking me to the login page, and then I am performing the login process into it. Once I finish the login process, I will go and log out from the profile. So here is the login logout process. robot related code, and then I'm quitting the browser. Now to run this, we don't run it through the code. We run it through an XML file because it's TestNG process. TestNG expects you to run it through XML file. So if you run this through an XML file, you get the output. Your parameterization happens over here. So this way you'll see the execution is taking place. The data is entered. I am logged into the GitHub account. Now it will go log out and it will quit. So a short process which will give you an idea how the automation actually works. And to write the code, you have to learn lot many things, like how to locate an element, various techniques are there, how to perform actions, there are techniques, how to do the coding well, that is there. Then we also train you what all variety of features and functionalities are available. When we talk about features and functionality, how to handle those functionality? Are they directly available for action, or you need something to do in a little different way, or you have to, which type of technique will work for a particular feature and functionality? What are the strategies that you should play? All sort of information that you want that will make you work in Selenium profile, we give you all sort of knowledge in the live class. So this particular course goes somewhere around 36 hours and plus. Why I say plus? Because sometimes based on the learning journey, I do extend my classes by a day or two, because I don't believe in compromising on the quality of the training. When it comes to training, it has to be such that the day you close the session and you practice the thing, you should get a job. And that's the only basic aim that I implement for my teaching process. In that process, whatever I tell you, you have to finish the things on time. This makes you more knowledgeable also, and you get good hands-on experience also. Thank you guys. Bye-bye.